What's going on, everybody? Doc from Average Gamer Guys, back yet again. A little bit more Halo Wars 2 campaign action. Today we're talking Mission 10, the Foundry. We're getting close. I'm getting excited. This mission is actually quite fun. It's a little bit of a change of pace kind of from the last two missions. We've been doing a little bit more defense. This time we're kind of going to offense, so it's pretty neat. So right up front here, in just a few seconds, I'll pop a screen up. But quite a few things to do in this mission, but definitely as compared to the last few missions, especially kind of the sniper one that we just made it through, this one feels pretty easy to get all of the optional and all of the bonus objectives, as long as you're just kind of paying attention. And I'll show you a point. There is a point where you're complete with everything and you can kind of just go on a rampage. So popping them up right now. Again, if you're going to pause, this is a great chance to do it. Pause this, just run this through as you're playing the game. So hopefully that's helpful for you. You got three optional. These are pretty easy. You're crippling some banished facilities. You're destroying the fortress in under 20 minutes. So that one you got to kind of pay a little bit of attention to. And then you're not going to lose the Scarab. Then you got four bonus. You're going to end up getting a Scarab here in this mission. So spoilers, sorry if you are already past this point and you didn't want to know that. You got to kill 25 structures with him. You got to destroy 15 Blisterbacks. So we'll see that really... banished unit kind of for the first time. And then you got to destroy 15 Banshees with either Infantry or Wolverines. So this is kind of a nice bonus objective here, just for the sole fact that we get a little bit more flexibility for what we want to use to finish them. And then you need to kill squads with the Scarab. You need to kill 40, so it's quite a big number. You're going to start out with a pretty stout force here. Just kind of move them around. You'll run into your first cinematic, which kind of calls in your first blister back. And a lot of this is just honestly going to be just kind of moving through the map normally. So there's two Phoenix logs, and we'll grab those pretty easily. There is one of the optional objectives, probably the one that most likely people will miss if they're not really doing a full explore, is going to be actually crippling the facilities. So there's three small mini bases on the map. You pretty much run straight into two of them. You could miss one, I guess, if you just don't push far enough, but there is one that's kind of off to the side, and if you don't kind of make it a priority to grab it, you'll not end up grabbing it. This one, you run pretty much right into it, and this will actually key up the objective for you. Same thing, you get a second of the blister backs. Now, don't worry about the blister backs. I was getting to the point where I thought I was kind of near the end of the mission, and I still didn't have it. It was the only one I didn't have out of all of the objectives. And there's a pretty stout force that you'll run into near the end of this mission. So I definitely recommend, one, if you're playing on a higher difficulty, I finally switch back to easy, unlike the other day when I was playing Mission 9. But you'll run into a pretty stout force at the end, so if you're playing on a higher difficulty, just make sure you got a pretty good amount of troops. And that's probably one thing I would end up changing for my playthrough here, is just later on you'll get a base, you'll start to be able to do some build stuff, and when you do that, I kind of omit the armory, at least for a little while, but we'll talk that when we get there. I would just recommend putting that up first before you get to the final push, but we got a little bit of ways to get there. I've tried to cut through again all the cutscenes and all that stuff to make these a little bit shorter, but I still do want to do a good full walkthrough for you guys. So hopefully if you're just looking for the objectives and what they are, again, go back about a minute or 2 minutes at this point, and just pause that screen, and that will be all of them for you. So I do like this mission. It's pretty cool. You get a good, you get a good amount of diversity as far as what enemy units you end up facing. You're gonna, obviously, one of your bonus objectives is kill Banshees, so you're going to see quite a bit of Banshees. You see the Blisterbacks, the Banished Blisterback in full force at this point. So you get a good amount. You get a lot of infantry. You'll see some vehicles, some wraiths, and some things like that. So the only thing I really want to focus on here is I power up archer missiles, or I power up the turret. Spam those leader powers. You should have plenty, especially once you get your base up. You should have plenty of resources, so you don't have to worry about that. I don't do as much of a resource grab in this one. Here you'll see it's your first good chance to grab some Banshees. Same thing here though, you're going to get plenty of chances to destroy those. It is nice to grab a couple. with your ODSTs that they so nicely drop in, or you got a couple sets of Marines with you. So if you can prioritize those a little bit with those guys, you shouldn't have any problem picking up the 15 that you need. And then once you go to get your base build, which will happen here in just a few minutes, the first thing I make is just Wolverines, because you'll get a couple, I'd say two or three waves of Banshees that will end up flying in, and when they do that, you just want to have something there that can pretty easily take them out. Because if Alice, she will remain outside of the Scarab. If she ends up destroying them, you don't get it. It doesn't count. Oh, hi, that's my dog. Sorry about that. So just make sure you're focusing again with those Wolverines as soon as you can buy them. Get them built, and again, you'll have no problem knocking out the Banshees. And again, you can use the infantry that you have as well, so you can set those up. They actually get a couple kills for me, so it is pretty nice. Right there, you're going to fight an honor guard. I am going to be honest, I didn't even see him go down. Again, use your leader powers really well in this mission. Your turret, I'm really liking the turret drop. It's really good. There's going to be some great opportunities for some archer missiles. Here's your first of two Phoenix logs. Again, you could, I guess, maybe sort of kind of drive right by this, but not really. Kind of got a circle path around this Scarab. And it is really cool. I am kind of happy that they allow us to jack a Scarab, kind of like they did in Halo Wars 1. So seeing some similarities, but definitely not going to be mad about it. And the nice thing is, again, me and Sloth have talked in some other videos. The art style on this is awesome. They did the Banished really cool. They made these Scarab look absolutely awesome. And the sounds, like, again, I hate to go on tangents here, but the sounds and how they produced this game, they did an awesome job. So here is going to be your first great chance to work your other bonus objective, which is to kill 40 squads. With the Scarab. What I do is I push this thing up front, right up front. I keep it up front at all times, and I let it really just do the work. Now, I probably should have saved that restoration drone to make sure that I could hit the Scarab, because you do have to kind of watch the Scarab's health, even on easy mode. There are some instances where I get it in where it gets down to like red health, just because I'm kind of letting it run alone. You really shouldn't ever end up losing it as long as you're just kind of paying attention to it, but definitely give it some protection. And what I kind of do more towards the end, because it can't hit those air units, I just have it focus on everything else. Make sure it's, you know, obviously hitting those infantry squads, because that's going to be your best bet to knock that bonus objective out. And just pair it up with some Wolverines. If you do that, get a couple Wolverines, get this thing rolling around, you're going to be absolutely fine. You're not going to knock out all of these optional and bonus objectives. So comparatively to a lot of the other missions, as long as you build right, and you just kind of move throughout the map, you should be absolutely fine. And again, just paying attention to your time. You'll see here, once we destroy this base and we get a base built up, there's going to be a little timer that ticks down. You got to destroy a base in a certain amount of time. I think they give you 30 minutes up front. One of your optional objectives is to do it in under 20. Really not hard at all. The hard time for this mission was 25 minutes. Honestly, you probably move a lot faster than I did. There's one or two things that I end up destroying that I probably don't need to. Here's another great chance for the Scarab to both get some infantry squad kills as well as some building kills. So as far as the building kills go, if you destroy everything around the base and then destroy the base, you really only have to destroy the main buildings plus maybe one or two from the side. I wasn't sure at this point on the other side buildings I was going to need to take. Scarab moves kind of slow, so I didn't really want to have him moving back and forth too much. So I kind of take an extra few minutes. There's plenty of those little small structures that you can absolutely take out. You get a couple more Blisterbacks here that you can add up to your 15 as well. Just make sure you're focusing. I always try to focus on the turrets first, or whatever's dealing the damage. You know, Scarab's, he's going to do a great job of just destroying the side structures anyways. A lot of times he'll even just step on some stuff and it ends up blowing it up, so that is nice. But yeah, so you really don't need to take out too many side structures. Maybe hit three or four, especially. There's some ones that are pretty close to these barricades that you have to knock out. If you do that, you hit all that stuff, and then you take out the standard bases and then one of the side main bases, you should hit you should hit your 25 structures without much trouble. Again, if you do see yourself getting towards the end of the mission, and I'll show you kind of where that marker is as far as the map is concerned, you know, you can always kind of go back and clean up some of these small bases. But here, it's probably where you could save yourself a little bit of time. Because again, I key in and I don't really know. Alright, well, there's a structure, we'll just destroy it. We'll just kind of help rack up the town a little bit. So, not a bad idea, especially if you're going to wait for this base to build up. You might as well knock a few out. And again, I just keep moving these guys forward. I try to separate the Marines at this point. Because again, here's your other real good chance to get a couple Banshee kills. If you kind of push the group like I did right there and then get your Marines and ODSTs up. They actually do a really good job, as well they should. They're strong against air, so they should knock that stuff out pretty quickly. So no real worries there. Again, you get a couple more waves in. I don't really worry about building any defenses on the base. I will at the end kind of build some turrets just to get that going. Again, Restoration Drones, probably want to upgrade that a little bit sooner, because again, you are going to be using it even on easy. Your Scarab will take some damage, especially if you do what I did and just push it up front. Make sure that it gets all those kills. But right here, I'm healing it up. I'm letting the base build up. I build a garage immediately. As soon as it's up, just build the garage. Here you see the optional objective pop up, and there you go. There's your 30-minute time countdown. So as long as you destroy the base with at least 10 minutes remaining on that, you will make that optional objective. There is two skulls for this mission as well. So just make sure, again, if you're doing what I'm doing and try to get you know, one single playthrough and get a lot of these achievements done, of which there's going to be quite a few when we end up finishing this, if you kind of follow the guide, so that will be nice. You'll also pick up your skulls at the same time. So again, here, just kind of base building, move these guys around. There are some supplies you can pick up, so it doesn't hurt. I end up finding myself a little low on energy for whatever reason, that energy is especially important because I go to make a couple Wolverines here, and I realize I don't have enough. So just make sure you're picking up a couple of the power generators, make yourself a couple generators, and again, I just kind of spam supply pads in there for the rest of it. I think I do two generators, one garage, and the rest supply pads. My only recommendation would be, one, you don't have to destroy that barricade at all, so don't even worry about it. For whatever reason, though, this map does end up giving you that mini base right where your troops start. It probably gave it to me sooner, I just didn't notice it. But if you do destroy that barricade, then your forces, if you create anything there, can run to you. The only change I would make, and I end up doing this with that first mini base way far in the back, which wasn't a bad idea to be honest, but is to make an armory as well. Like I said, I'm already sitting at, I'll hit my population cap with one more Wolverine, which I think only gives me like three. And that's purely based off of what I started with. So I finally noticed this base is mine to take. Eventually, at some point, we'll go over it. But I do end up destroying that that barracks that they have back there. You don't need that barracks, in my opinion, at all. And I end up putting the armory there. You can put the armory at this base. You'd be perfectly fine doing that. Just do one less supply pad, and you should be all set. So at this point, again, I'm moving the Scarab up. I'm just kind of getting this base set. You could honestly do this simultaneously as long as you got some infantry with you, and honestly, really just your Wolverines and your Scarab. That would be the two things that I would just pair up and just have them start moving forward. Again, I think I could have knocked this out in part time, especially now, you know, knowing what I had needed to run into, what I needed to build, and kind of where the, you know, the big group spawns for enemies were. Should be absolutely fine, or at least get very close. The nice thing, again, if you just do exactly as I do, you'll end up getting that gold medal. We absolutely crush the gold medal score yet again. So it seems like, especially on easy, that was a good recommendation. I'm glad I did it. Here I'm making the armory, because again, I realized my population cap isn't anywhere close to what I want it to be. I'm only sitting on three Wolverines, which honestly you could do with three Wolverines. Just having a few more will actually kind of help you near the end of the mission, especially if you are like me. I pretty much kept everything else alive throughout the entirety of the mission, because again, the Scarab is so much. So this is one of kind of the big fights. I end up calling this in. This is a great archer missile for me. Again, those things are really strong. the Locust can actually take quite a bit of damage. That thing was pretty much right inside of that. But another good chance you're going to get quite a few of your Blisterback kills here. So they kind of spread these out throughout the map a little bit. Which you're going to see would just absolutely decimate through all that stuff. And then you get a bunch of your infantry squads. Now, what I probably should have done instead of doing what I did right there was kind of continue to focus on the Blisterbacks. But what I do, and I like that play, is to call on that turret right there, let that thing just shoot those. Again, I'm really a big fan of the deployable turret. It's really strong. You can see how fast it kind of just rips through that. And then I think it ends up picking up a couple of the infantry squads, but you have plenty of these that your Scarab can take down. I think this is one of the points where this thing gets kind of lower health. You throw some restoration drones on it just to keep it up, because there is a base here too. So again, quite a few structures for you to be able to take out. You don't really need to take out many of the side structures like I did. If you get to the point, I'll show you where it is. Where again, it's kind of nearing the end of the mission and you're still not at it. I'll show you a few spots that you could definitely pick up some more. So here I'm going to start to kind of make my way, move my Marines forward, move my infantry forward, kind of get them staged and set up, because I do know, again, just keep in the back of your mind, you do need to get those fancy kills. At this point, the Scarab's just kind of going to work. I'm kind of micromanaging him a little bit, which is totally fine, and that'll just help you pick up some base structure. The nice thing about the Scarab is it absolutely tears through these buildings, so it makes real quick work of this. They do end up getting this. They do end up getting that Wraith out, and so far in this mission, it seems like just about more so than any other. They're ramping up a little bit of the difficulty for the Banished, just as the, and, you know, as far as the fact that their base is actually continuously producing. They kind of just continue to pump stuff out, especially when you're close to it, you start to destroy it. Let's push onto the Halo Forge. So just keep an eye on that, but you should make quick work of this, especially if you're doing it on easy. Which is definitely how I recommend moving through this. At this point, again, I need the armory. And at that point right there, I have the energy. So I'm upgrading some things, just making sure I have enough supplies. But here, I probably should have upgraded my headquarters to get it to the next level. Just because that would have allowed me to upgrade my logistics a little bit faster. So again, probably don't need to do this here where I'm trying to get the Scarab to shoot that. He kind of gets a little turned around and acts a little silly. But yeah, so we're just kind of continuing through. We'll come up to our second of the Banished little mini bases that we need to take out. Again, here's another great opportunity. As soon as you kind of get that base built, just expect a pretty good amount of troops to come in from that right-hand side. Because again, that white portion on the map right here is kind of your gateway to the end. So don't push too far into that. I mean, you can a little bit if you want to. But just kind of follow the guide here. Continue to push forward instead of to the left. And then you're also going to have to make a trip and push down kind of behind you. You'll see kind of where I start to send these guys. Because there is your final Banished mini base that you need to take out. Again, you can upgrade this base. You don't really have to do too much to it. The Banshees will do a good amount of damage if you don't pay attention to your Scarab here. He's getting pretty low on health. But here's another great chance for you to get a bunch of Banshee kills. I'm moving the Scarab around. I realize that's probably the way to go, because again, you got your little marker there. Let's not go that way. You're going to get more infantry squads. You're getting your restoration drones. I recommend powering those up with your leader powers pretty much first. Because you are going to be using it quite a lot, especially when you push the Scarab up front. And there we go, we just hit the squads right there. We've got plenty of other squads to kill, so that's a good kind of space for that. At this base, I don't really do much of anything special. At this point, I probably could have broken off that group right there, but again, I don't need the Scarab to kill squads anymore, so I can kind of take a little bit of luxury in that and start to move some other troops up. Again, the only thing you want to be cognizant of is your Scarabs, or your Scorpions, and Alice will shoot your air units, especially your Banshees. So just make sure you're kind of watching out for that. You still do need to pick up the kills with your Wolverines or your infantry. And this really, it kind of goes on autopilot here. Again, this is one of three, so your second mini base that you're going to take out. You get a couple more Blisterbacks here. You're going to absolutely eviscerate all of those enemies there. I realize that he's going to be fine. I realize I probably shouldn't have pushed those guys up right in there. I should have started moving them back. But you really do have plenty of time for this mission. I build up a few defenses because, again, you'll see one or two waves of units kind of come harass that base a little bit. And here's where the point where I do start kind of moving everything back, getting everything set, and have them start to kind of move around. Again, I realize here should have just upgraded my headquarters on that first base you get a little bit faster. Here's the one Banished mini base, and as well as the other Phoenix log that you might miss. So you obviously destroyed all that stuff, and there were a bunch of buildings in the way earlier, and if you're not paying attention, you could pretty easily roll by that, destroy that second mini base, and then be like, oh, well, I didn't get them all. Where was the third one? So just kind of pay attention to that. Again, I kind of split the troops. I send my Wolverines and my Scarab to just do the work, finish off some stuff here. I also recommend actually building on the mini base pads, because if the Banished you get a unit over there, they will rebuild it. Not that it will hurt you, you've already destroyed it, but it can be kind of annoying because they'll make some units out of it. Keep your Wolverines kind of close to your base, as well as a couple infantry, and they will take care of some more Banshee kills for you. At this point, I'm just kind of probing forward. I think, and again, right there, we just hit the Banshees, so not difficult at all. You're going to see plenty of them. And especially if you make a couple Wolverines, you will be all set. And I'm glad they gave us the option for that. I'm glad it wasn't like just infantry or anything like that, because that would have made it a little tougher. But here, you got a nice, pretty good core group that you can send down here. You're going to get a couple more Blisterback kills. I think you could honestly finish the Blisterbacks without moving back here. But again, you're trying to finish everything in one go. So just make sure you don't miss this little Banished mini base. And I don't take my own advice here. I kind of just roll past this. and they, by the time I end up getting back to it, they build on it. So just make sure you're building on it. There we go. We knocked out the three production facilities. So that was pretty easily done. I am going to grab this energy, although probably didn't really need it at this point. You can make yourself a little bit shorter path. I realize that after that, you could destroy that other barrier. And that would, you know, obviously make it so you don't have to take such a path to get around to it. But at the same time, going the way we did is perfectly fast enough, so you should be all set. And you're seeing at this point, I'm about 12 minutes into the timer. Plenty of time. I'm going to have no issues finishing off the rest of this base in about 8 minutes. And again, they're going to continue to send troops. You get a pretty good wave right here of stuff from the reinforcement side. The final base that you end up having to kill. And at this point, it's kind of no holds barred. I've gotten the base building kills that I need with the Scarab. I've gotten the infantry squad kills I need with the Scarab. And I've also gotten the Banshee kills with the Scarab. So we're pretty much all set along the lines for everything. I finished off all of the production facilities. We're working the 20 minutes piece. And, you know, we're just keeping the Scarab up at this point. The only thing I have remaining is just a couple Blisterbacks, which we will grab here very shortly, as soon as we push into this final area. And I realize, again, I'm like rolling past this. When you destroy that third and final mini base, whichever one it happens to be, I believe that Phoenix log you can see right here will actually spawn in. So that'll give you your second one of two. In this map. Again, they do send an engineer and then he ends up rebuilding. So just build on the base plot. Build the turret like at least. Because that will kind of keep things away and then it'll keep an eye on that spot. So you can end up doing what I do here and just build on it. You really don't have to put anything on it. On the higher difficulties, you may need the supplies or you may need that area to help you rebuild your troops before you make this final push. So at this point, we're all set. We've got everything set we want. I've got a bunch of Wolverines. I do power up reinforcements, but I don't really need it. I think 100 was fine, but might as well do it, right? And so at this point, we're ready for the final push. We've got everything we need, minus the Blisterback kills, and we will pick up quite a few here near the end of this. So I just bring everybody in. Again, I've got a couple turrets on each base, so they should be fine. We get our leader powers ready to go, and we just make the push. Now, this is a pretty good fight, to be honest. So I definitely recommend have your Scarab up front. Keep an eye on it. Ideally, you go into this final push with restoration drones, but I realize I got about 6 minutes left before that optional objective expires on me, so I don't want to miss that. So we're going to get in here and do this again. If you didn't get the Banshee kills at this point, there's quite a few more you're going to be able to pick up. You get quite a few other squads that you can knock out. And then here we'll see, I think there's Blisterbacks kind of set up on the side as well. I make what I thought was going to be an awesome archer result, what I should have done is hit it on the front group. Kind of got a two-layered approach there. I dropped some ODSTs in because we have the room. Dropped some Lotus Mines. I think I drop a turret here in a second. And then I power up to get my restoration drone back here in a second and drop it. So again, a pretty good fight. You're going to see they bring in kind of a wave of Blisterbacks. There's, what, five sitting right there. So plenty of chance to finish knocking those out. And again, a pretty good fight. This is on easy difficulty. But the fact that you got all this stuff flowing in, to continue to pump wraiths out of this base that's sitting right there. You get two more Blisterbacks coming in. You get a bunch more Banshees. So on higher difficulties, you definitely would outnumber the anti-air units, your Wolverines, more so. I make a couple Scorpions. I don't even think I end up getting them in. But definitely take a second and maybe upgrade some troops. Maybe make a few Scorpions to help you with this final push. And then just have a lot of air, anti-air. Because again, you're going to see, and you saw right there, plenty of Banshees to hit. Plenty of Blisterbacks that fly in. So your guys will be able to do quite a bit of good damage to those guys. If you have that kind of setup, because I only have about, I think I got four right there, so we take care of them pretty quickly, but at higher difficulties, I know that can be a little bit tougher, and again, they're going to continue kind of harass you from the sides. I used clones for the first time. Maybe on the higher difficulties is something that you'll want to use. I don't know how much it actually helps. It doesn't seem like it helped that much. And then I just focused right in on the base. We protected the Scarab. We're going to knock the base out, and that should finish us up right here. So pretty quick, easy mission. Again, part time 20. Oh, I said 25 minutes. Part time's 22 minutes. I did it in 26. Boom. I was able to knock this out on the first one, so we're knocking out the Foundry achievement, which is pretty nice. 27 minutes knocked this out, so I get a pretty good combat bonus. And I get a pretty good time bonus. And again, as has been par with a lot of these other missions, we're absolutely crushing the score. Doing it on easy, you don't need any skulls. You can play through this the first time, and you'll end up racking up a good portion of the achievements, especially if you're hitting the golds and getting all the bonus and optional objectives. Again, two skulls. I don't exactly remember what they were tied to, but then we also have the two Phoenix logs that we grabbed, and we are all set here. Quite a good objective score too, because you got a lot of additional stuff to do. And here's kind of your overall screen. Again, if you watch through this and now you're going to go play, here's another great chance to pause. Just keep this up while you're rolling through, just so you can kind of keep your mind on what you need to do. And then I cut as much as I can out of me checking this, but just check this regularly as you roll through these missions, as you've probably been doing for the other nine. And just make sure you know you're tracking your progress. The only other one, again, just to kind of focus on, just make sure you're working that under the 20 minutes piece. Once you see that timer come up, just kind of make sure you're making steady progress forward, but you shouldn't have really any trouble doing that at all. So hopefully you guys are enjoying the series. I have really enjoyed making these, and hopefully these guides are really helpful, especially putting the bonus and optional objectives up front. So hopefully, again, these are things that you can just pause and use to your advantage while you're playing through. That way you can do what I'm doing and try to knock it out on single playthrough. So we're going to finish up today. Missions 11 and 12 we will knock out. We will get those all done. So we'll have the whole campaign done. And then we got a bunch of other achievement guides that we put up last night up on the channel. So be sure to go check those out. Some really easy stuff to knock out, especially if you got a buddy that you can play with, me and Sloth. We just go 1v1 skirmish matches and can knock out quite a few achievements in a very short amount of time. So if you're kind of achievement hunting, that's a great way to go do it. So make sure you subscribe. Follow us on Twitter. Again, we'll tweet out every once in a while when we've got new stuff up. And if you're a subscriber, you'll see when we've got new videos up and when the next last two missions of this go up. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for the support. Let me know how I'm doing down in the comments below. And if there's anything you're struggling with, leave a comment, let me know. I've responded to a few of you, so I'm definitely here to help, and so is Sloth. And as well, I actually helped somebody boost the 25 waves achievement as well. So, you know, don't be afraid to hit me or Sloth up. Let us know what's giving you some trouble. We'll either give you some pointers or if we got some free time. We have no problem helping you out, knock out some of these missions. So again, thanks for watching. We will check you next time.